was kind of met in 2014, was I haven't looked at the expenditures, the operating expenditures yet, but you have 20 new positions requested, which is just under $700,000, just for the personnel cost. You have 21 upgrades requested for about $77,000. And again, you have those equipment needs, because there was no splosh of fund raise. You've got to look at general fund now to make some of those capital purchases.
Before you perhaps overreact to the request for 20 positions, be aware that for staff or an elected official to feel that they are being adequate in their presentation, it's network when they present us. It's necessary for them to be realistic as far as their expectation, but also to be realistic in telling you what they really assess as their needs. So if they do not come to you and say, I need five people, and you say, well, why are you not able to do this, why is it? You don't need five people, you didn't get it. Well, why did you not ask for five people? We would assess that. So it'll be a part of your assessment in the budget. It's not just a frivolous request in most cases.
So what's on the horizon? We're currently working on the 2014 budget. In July, we will have to say remarks for what you budgeted for prior to that. Whilst negotiations are still ongoing,
it's no small thing, Stephanie, that everyone involved keeps us in the black. And I have to be honest with you, it's been an eye-opener for me since I became commissioner, and the work that is done to make that happen. And, you know, I don't think you get enough credit for it. I don't think any of y'all get enough credit for it, but thank you for what you do. I mean, it makes our lives so much easier. You know, y'all sweating bullets to get it done, and then it's just presented to us in a meeting, but I appreciate it.
Stephanie and I have to be the ones to crunch the numbers, obviously. And sometimes we are the ones who bear bad news to the department gives some of the trips out here, but the service that the citizens continue to receive with the resources stretched far as high as they are is really due to the staff, not only the department, but the people that work under them. I think every one of them would say the same thing. But because of the efforts, and I will say primarily, I'm not excluding the elected officials, but primarily it's your staff, and you've already seen what the largest cuts in the firm. Your staff that is directly under your supervision. Work exception part to do a job which they're proud of and you to be proud of and serve the citizen that they're going to do it in an economic way. That may sound like what to somebody that may say they're going to get up, but it's actually a true statement. I think we can each one here give you examples of staff that not only say that but exemplify that and that work together. So they do appreciate hearing that, because we usually appreciate it, and to say that to a particular employee, because they don't expect to hear from the public that they're doing their job, and that's not negative in any way, it's simply a fact, but to hear occasional appreciation, is that a fair statement, Stephanie?
I need to pat on the back every now and then.
Well, you know, it goes a long way from instead of kicking.
Well, it's a testament to leadership. So, you know, we have, you know, you're the one that, Joe, you're the one that's at the head of that. And I think it's a, you know, leadership's top down. I appreciate your leadership. You know, when I pass by the meeting room when you're having your staff meetings, and I peek my head in there, I don't see any weak links in the chain. And that's a testament to you. So I appreciate that. And then the way that we've hired people, we have good people with a lot of integrity, and it matters.
I have a question. On the 30 fewer positions now than we had in 2009, what services have we cut? Because we've lost those
connections. Yeah, I have two and three jobs. Those services
have been cut. Services have been
sacrificed. What functions? I mean, how can you do
that? When we went through these reductions, the assignment from the county commissioners at that time was obviously to do it in the most pragmatic way possible and not lose any service. So it's all of us have said they're doing two or three jobs. Where, for instance, we had three people. Linda is doing all of that herself, just as one thing. And I can go through the other departments as well. And staff that they lost. We had two people doing the job, doing all those responsibilities and duties from the person that had to be on top of the person did all of that. And that did not need any increases in the group. Quite frankly, I did not get a lot of pushback from anybody. To the contrary, everybody said, you tell us what we need to do to make the process continue to work. That was not an uncomfortable. I mean, the department is. I mean, I might have an individual that came and said, look, I know some of these guys, and I know my situation, I know your situation, and I know somebody's going to go home. Volunteer to be that person, I'll stand up because I can get by better than they can. When a guy comes in and looks you in the eye and tells you that more than the situation that you're in, it's a lot of fear.
One of the things got really tough, one of the things that we were told was that it's hard, we're all going to fall down, but we'll be a stronger government on the other side. And I think that you can look at the information that you've already seen today through what you'll see tomorrow and see how we are in that stronger government.
But I'll right along with Tom, you go back and look at the other information that's been presented, the graphs and the charts and the trends and everything to tell that I haven't had anybody in the community talk to me about the lack of services that there's been a fall off on the services. And so that's a credit to staff. That even in these tough times and reductions and funds and people, the county has still been able to provide the services that the citizens and not only but that they requested.
Well, it means we're more efficient. If we've lost 30 positions but hadn't lost any service, that means y'all become more efficient. And as painful as it's been, at least it sounds like a step in the right direction. If you can lose 30 people and not lose the services, something must be done right.
Well, it's also like running the maximum marking in. You can do that for a while.
There's a big difference in the efficiency and then being overloaded. And right now, I think what I'm seeing is that everybody has really stepped up, took a lot more time, actually working hard, and by doing that, of course, that's created some efficiency by doing that. It's called that situation. But right now, everybody's working as hard as they can possibly work to make things work within the situation.
To be honest with you, Joe, I'm somewhat concerned. During our orientation, we spoke about just how, the county government has taken on the brunt of the burden in order to preserve the military where it is. And so, the fact is, this county is constantly growing. It's going to continue to grow. And so, I just have to say, I appreciate what y'all do, but
not a lot of things to think about.
Yeah, there's some hard decisions.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Well, you have basically picked, as I've said before, all the way from the party thing, if you want cuts, and continue that level of service. And I am not saying you have anything that we continue to operate in the way we are today, not begin a new service. There's been, during our budget, there's been some very, very hard decisions to make. Civil bullet can get to at this point, but it is going to be every year I've said this to staff or entire year, this budget is very difficult in one previous. But I think they all agree, I have a lot to enjoy. And they, every time, they brought their needs to us, and that's what I've asked them to do. But then, you know, staff and I go to the budget room. Just us in there crunching these numbers, we have to deal with the whole hard reality. And when I've given those numbers back to those department heads, not the first one of them has kicked back and said, I can't do this. They all said, it's going to be hard, but we'll make it work. So that, and as of yet, they didn't even do that. But that all skipped up was absolutely as nice as it is. Stephanie, could you run quickly through these two?